Agnes. Agnes. What is it? What have I done to you that I cannot drink water and keep cup in this house? Eh? What is it? Have I done anything wrong by coming to marry your family? Eh?
Only why do you like to shout, sir? Eh? Every little thing, you will just be shouting. Just because my sister's daughter wants to come and stay with us, you are shouting.
Mm. Mm. Your brother already lives here. And I'm still praying to God in his infinite mercy not to allow him to sell me and my destiny. Now your niece too wants to come and live here. Very soon your village chief priest too will say he wants to come and live in our house. Happy?
But Oni, what do you want me to do now? Eh? She said Mimi will just stay here. Small, just small. Eh? Until they settle their problem. Biko Nunu. Plus, you know I like to help my people.
Yes. I know. Mother Teresa. I know. See, why don't you just pack everybody in your village once and for all? Why this doing it this one by one? Just pack them once and for all and bring them here. Let them come and live here. Or have people finish in your place. Eh? Gather all of them once and for all and just bring them. Bring them. Because you are the only one that has a house in Lagos. And once they open their mouth like this, the next thing is for you to give them invitation. Yeah.
Honey, see, I don't worry. After this one, I will not invite anybody to this house again. Eh? See, I have a surprise for you when you come back. The mama.
Ah, my friend, forget it. Forget it. It will not work. Odeshi, it will not work. See, that used to work before, but not anymore. I have been delivered. Yes. See, your whole family cannot come and live in our house. It is not possible. We are not running a charity organization now. What is it? Eh? See, okay, fine. If your niece must come to live here, then that chimney, that smoke exhaust that you call a brother, must look for another place to live. Simple.
How do you want him to live now? You know he has been looking for a job since last year and he hasn't found anything.
Bam! Yes, he cannot. How can he find? He has not found a job, yet he has been able to find everywhere that they are selling weed in this neighborhood. See, I don't even care. I don't want to know where he goes to live. If he likes, let him go and live under the bridge. After all, when I came to Lagos, I stayed in the motor park.
Hey, honey, you can lie. You that you were living in your uncle's mansion for 5 years.
I have said all that I have to say. I am late for work.
I have said all I have to say. I'm late for work.
First, it was her brother that started living in my house. Now, her sister's daughter too has come. Very soon, before you know what is happening, her entire village people will move into my house. Before you know it, or before you can say Jack Robinson, I will be the only person that is not living inside my own house.
That's not possible.
Oh, is that what you think? Look, I think she's planning a coup. Because look at it, yes, look at it. It has all the complete ingredients of a coup d'etat. Yes, she will gather enough people into my house. Then when she has the right numbers, they will overthrow me.
Okay, so why don't you also bring your own people to come and be living in the house too as well?
Come, what is it now? No, what is going on? Has my wife bribed you?
No, of course not. I'm just joking.
No, why is it that every time I come here to complain about her, you are always taking her side?
I'm not trying to take anybody's side. All I'm saying is, if she has her own people staying in the house and you have your own people staying in the house too as well, then there will be a balance.
Ah, don't you think so? Balance, yeah. Mm. So you are telling me now to start running a charity organization?
That's been hospitable.
It is not only hospitable, it's suitable. So I should now bring in consumers into my house to devour everything I have in the house. That your plan will not work. It has failed. It has failed. Go and meet your sponsors that you failed.
But they're your family members too as well. They're your in-laws.
No, did they send you?
Mirabel, how are you?
I'm fine, Uncle. Uncle, I bought you a gift.
Okay.
It's called Papa's cap. It's for old people.
Thank you. Thank you.
Uncle, wear it now.
Thank you. I will wear it later.
No, wear it now. Let me see if it fits you. You see?
It's fine.
So you're not looking at so.
Mirabel, take your bag inside. Huh?
How did you know?
He's in school. Just take your bag inside.
Okay. Eh? I'm glad with the
couple. Fine girl. See? She likes you.
Like kill you, dear. Which like? Because she brought me old people's cap. Me and her father, who is older? Nonsense.
But it fits you.
Wait now, we're not both old people.
Yeah.
I'm not old, though, because...
Daddy, what is Mirabel doing in my room?
She'll be staying with us for some time, so you have to share your room with her.
But I don't want to share my room with anybody.
What is the problem? There are two beds there. She will not be disturbing you.
And what about my privacy?
Which privacy? You are 13. You have no privacy. When I was your age, I was still taking my bath in the village square.
Daddy, that was in the Stone Age. That was in the Stone Age. This is the New Age now. Things have changed. I don't share my room with anybody.
Interesting. See, this one that you are just shouting, your room. Let me ask you some questions. Do you know how much a bag of cement costs?
No.
Block, uncle?
No.
What of sand?
No.
And you're here claiming a whole room to yourself. Eh? My friend, will you get out of here?
That and is not fair. I don't share my room with that. Ah.
Look at this. This is Agama Lizard. Eh? Come. See, this is why telling me I grew up in the Stone Age. How old do these children even think I am?
Junior, what are you watching?
None of your business.
Ha! None of your business. I've not watched this one before. Let me watch it with you. Ha! None of your business. This movie looks interesting. Are you doing your homework?
Yes.
Do you want me to help you?
No, mind your business. Mirabel, do you know Mass?
Yes.
Can you help me?
No, I'm busy.
What are you doing?
I'm minding my business.
Help me now.
Say please.
Please.
I can't hear you.
Please,
He's setting fire to his trousers now.
You are so funny.
I'm telling you.
Mommy, thank you for bringing Mirabel to this house. She's the best. She's like a sister I never had.
Haven't you told him?
tell me what?
Mama, Mirabel is going home tomorrow.
Bam.
Why?
Her parents are divorcing and they asked me to bring her back.
No, why can't she stay here?
She's not our child, no.
Elise adopt her now. I need a sister.
Just say that you need somebody that will be helping you to do your assignment.
And daddy, this is not fair. This is not, you guys don't want me to be happy in this house.
I think it is going to affect him. You know they are getting closer.
Oh, damn, forget that thing. Yes, he just doesn't want to be doing his assignment by himself. That's all. Don't mind him. Nah, beg. Okay. Let us resume this. I'm telling you.
PC, don't come here. Peace. Peace at last. I mean, imagine a young man like me wearing a old papa's cap. Nonsense. Now, if I can just get rid of the other one too, then I will have perfect peace. Perfect peace! Huh? Imagine! Oh, thank you, Jesus. Agnes, what is happening here?
The judge asked me if I want to stay with my father or my mother. So I told them that I want to stay with you and my auntie. We're going to be a happy family.
Agnes!
I don't think it is a bad idea. You don't want her to stay with that drunkard father now.
Oh.
Uncle, are you not happy that I'm back?
I'm happy, oh. I'm very happy. I'm very, very happy.
But why is your face not happy?
That is how God designed my face, oh.
Maybe it's because you're not wearing your papa's cap. You see? Say you're not looking happy. Auntie, snap pose.
Everybody, smile. Mm-hmm.